Welcome to the Hydrogen Fuel Cells and Batteries Group Exhibition here at Hannover Fair. Baxi Innotec was the BYD theme strategic approach to the prepare for the market launch of its fuel cell product. Please, ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome the Division Manager of Research and Development from Baxi Innotec, Mr. Philipp Klose.
Thank you, Alexander. Hello.
So you found the way to Hannover?
Certainly. We've been here quite a few times in the past couple of years, so that was no difficulty.
So not only easy to get here, the company that you're leading in research and development is called Baxi Innotec. What is it all about?
Well, Baxi Innotec is the so-called competence center for fuel cell technology in the BDR Thermea group. And BDR Thermea is amongst the four largest boiler manufacturers in Europe. So we are typically in a traditional field of business, and with our division in Hamburg, we have the innovative part in the fuel cell segment, developing small micro CHP systems based on PEM fuel cell technology. So Baxi Innotec itself, we've gone through a couple of name changes over the years, but we have been active in that area since the late 90s to develop the small scale CHP for of fuel cell systems for the application, the stationary application in single family households. And we have gone through several systems generations, and on our booth you can currently see the so-called Gamma Premio system.
So you had a lot of changes, not only within the company, also in the product development. And talking about research and development, it's for me very interesting to see, is your product going into the market soon?
That's certainly our target. On the booth of the Initiative Fuel Cell, you can see many fuel cell system manufacturers. And the good news is that we have really approached the stage of market introduction with all the different products that are exhibited there. With our own development with the Gamma Premio, we are currently in the field trial phase. So we have stopped, we have completed the installation phase in the Kallux field trial program here in Germany. So in that program, we are still doing the operation of the systems, the monitoring, and there are several supporting measures that we are currently being active in. And we have also placed Gamma Premio units in the so-called Enefield European field trial. So we are doing field trials in that program as well. You were questioning or asking for, are we close to market introduction with the product? Yes, I think we are. We have learned quite a bit over the past couple of years with this technology. It's not only a technical development, it's also a market development. And together with the other companies who are active in that area, we have been developing this market ever since. Currently, in the past couple of weeks, we have announced a new partnership together with Toshiba Fuel Cell Power Systems Corporation, and they will be our partner for the development of the actual market introduction product.
What is this kind of cooperation? What kind of aims did you set for this cooperation?
Well, that's an important question, but it's basically continuing what we have done in the past with our development partners. So we have always based our development on strategic partnerships with top-level companies in their specific area. And this is what we are continuing now together with Toshiba due to a couple of reasons. I think Toshiba is a company that has a very specific interest in this technology due to the activities in their home market in Japan, where they have sold more than 35,000 small CHP systems into the market already. So they have a very broad base, very good experience in this area, and the fuel cell technology is one of their key products, really, that they are pushing for the future. And
For me, it sounds like you're setting on a starting rocket.
Well, a starting rocket would be nice, but I think the market development in Europe will be steady, but maybe not as fast as a rocket. We will see a steady market growth, hopefully, over the next couple of years. And in general, if I may add that to your question, we are really continuing what we have been developing in the past. So we are basing our current development again on PEM technology. We have used PEM technology for our micro CHP system since the beginning of the years. We feel that this is really, at this point, the technology of choice due to start-stop capabilities and the lifetime matters. So, and around to, or let's say, to make this a real fuel cell product, it's not only a fuel cell engine which is needed, where we've worked together with Ballard, for example, in the past, so a similar relationship as what we're doing now with Toshiba, but it's the whole package that you need to look at. And Baxi Innotec, in a few years back, we were just supplying the system. With the Gamma Premio, we have already moved into the field of a complete system supplier. So it was not only the fuel cell heating system, but it was the complete package with the storage tank, the hydraulics, energy manager, the package that the customer really needs for the installation. And this is, of course, the same approach we are taking now in the cooperation with Toshiba. So Baxi Innotec in Hamburg will continue to be the competence center and development center for the fuel cell system package. We will take our defined components from the group, like condensing boilers or tank technology, also energy manager. We, of course, bring in all the expertise from the group to develop that, and with these components really create the fuel cell package for the end customer.
So my daddy is one of them. He likes to hear more about the fuel cells, and he will see our video. What can we promise him for his household directly from Baxi Tech?
Well, promises are, if they are directed into the future, sometimes a little difficult. But in general, let's say the fuel cell system that we are about to offer will bring customers like your dad the opportunity to have a lot of primary energy and CO2 savings. So in the range of 50% compared to maybe the system which is installed currently in the house. If we're looking at the European, or let's say the German market, we are in the range of 12.5 million installations with gas boilers. So all these areas, maybe not all of them, but these would be suitable for an installation of a gas-fired fuel cell system. And typically the boilers in these houses are in the range of maybe 20 years old. So highly inefficient from our current perspective. With the fuel cell technology, this would bring the opportunity to save primary energy, CO2, in the range of 50%. That's more a political goal, maybe, even though many people in Germany, as we all know, are supporting this task. But it would also bring financial savings to your dad. So. In just the operational savings, he could be in the range of 1,000 to 1,400 euros per year that he could save against his old boiler system. And if your dad, maybe it's more meta for yourself, but if your dad would be interested in building a new house, he would have to fulfill ENEF regulations in Germany. And with such a new and efficient fuel cell product, he would have the possibility maybe to save on in other areas, like insulation of the house, that might be quite substantial.
So this is a proposal, I take it. what is interesting, not only for my dad, of course, the development in complete. I see always a little bit hangover in policy, like they need to develop new kind of laws. They are thinking a lot about it to bring a new kind of frame into the laws to see worldwide. There are different thinkings about new regulations. Did you hear something that can help you?
Well, I mean, you're addressing a very wide field where we have many issues currently. There is, of course, this not only relates to fuel cell, it also relates to other CHP technologies in general. There's, of course, an issue with bureaucracy in Germany. You have to, if you install a CHP system, a fuel cell system in your house, you have many different applications which you need to fill out. You need to apply for funding via the BAFA program, and then you need to apply for a mineral oil tax refund. Separate form, you need to go into the CHP law to get your incentive for the electricity produced. You need to talk to your utility when you're installing this electricity producer, when you want to connect to the grid. So there's many areas where we need politics to facilitate the process for the end customer.
So first the process and first the bureaucracy, a little bit downer. It's too much. On the other hand, we are in Germany. It is too regulate here. There are a lot of countries, they don't over-regulate that much like we do in Germany. So if you had a free wish for a European politician in a decisive position, what kind of wish would you, what kind of question would you ask him?
Well, looking into the European legislation, we currently have quite a change coming up in the heating business, which is triggered by the labeling directive. So from 2015 onwards, we will have so-called energy labels on the product. We know these labels from maybe from refrigerators or TV, similar labels with ABC energy efficiency classes. And specifically for the CHP area, and therefore also for fuel cells, the current approach to the ranking of this label is for certain reasons which would lead too far now to discuss them here on stage today, but for certain reasons is not creating a level playing field for all the technologies. And that means CHP technology fuel cells will end up less favorite than what they could do or what they actually deserve to be. And this is, again, a small hurdle into the market. It's not the necessary big hurdle, but it's all these small areas that I was addressing earlier that are creating difficulties. But if I may send a wish to the German political side, if you allow for that, then it would certainly be very important because of the development we have reached now with all the systems that you can see on the booth of the Initiative Fuel Cell, that we are really looking to promote these systems towards the end customer. So I was talking earlier about our field trial projects, which we have done so far and which we are supporting further, but coming out of these field trials now, we really want to market the systems towards the end customer. And since the investment for such new and efficient technology is still quite expensive, quite high, due to the fact that we are only selling very small numbers, I think political support in terms of a market introduction program would be very important and a real push for the industry.
So this is the way to push, or one of the ways to push the product, or not only the product. First, they have to turn the mind. The customers have to turn their mind, maybe in general, maybe several did. So pushing from the political side is over the euro sign.
Pushing from the political side is over, of course, reducing bureaucracy. Also, in terms of a market introduction program, would be important. One word maybe to the customers. Part of the Kalux field trial also was some market research with the end customers involved in the program. And their perspective on the fuel cell technology. And it's very clear that we received an absolute positive message back from the market. They were very satisfied with the technology, would recommend it to neighbors or friends, the typical questions being asked in these market research programs. But the feedback we got from the experts doing the research was really that it's a tremendously positive result coming back for such a new technology. So the end customer is ready. The technology is ready. Now we have to see how we can bring those two together here in Germany.
Sounds very good and sounds like a nice ending word. Thank you very much, Philipp.
Thank you for your time.
Baxitech.